สวัสดีครับ Hello to everyone once again กสิทธิ์ พิรมยา from Bangkok This week or this time I would like to touch a bit on one of the biggest political news in Thailand for the past 2 to 3 weeks namely it's about the getting together of about 10 small minute political parties of Thailand which together they have about 30 members of parliament MPs in the House of Representatives so they constitute a force to be reckoned with in Thai political arena at this point in time why because they could become a very decisive swing vote either to go on the government side or to go on the opposition side especially for the upcoming censure no confidence vote motion in the House of Parliament during I think the last week of this May when the parliament reopens again there will be censure motion and debate on the confidence vote on the government under the leadership of General Prayut Chan Ocha why is the 30 votes so important it's because the number of seats on the government side and on the opposition side is quite parable quite you know not many differences but each side need these 30 votes to have the absolute majority for the opposition it would mean that they will have the enough number of votes to defeat the Prime Minister General Prayut Chan Ocha or to pass the motion of no confidence at the same time General Prayut Chan Ocha and his government also need these 30 seats in the parliament to defeat the motion of the opposition so in that sense these 30 seats of the smaller parties and so on has become very vital in the next I think parliamentary session in the month of May but compared to the swing votes in many of the countries democratic countries around the world especially in many of the smaller European countries or even in Japan or in Taiwan usually the swing votes do come from a group of independent member of parliament and what I mean by independent is that they don't belong to any political parties and they need not to belong to any political parties according to their constitution or their election law unlike in Thailand you know to become members of parliament you have to belong to a political party so in our system we do not have independent members of parliament okay in the parliament so in that sense we do not have this independent MPs to be the swing vote and so on okay that's the first point second in the I think the European or in the Taiwanese or in the Japanese parliament and so on the independent MPs usually constitute about 5 to 10 or at most 15% of the number of the whole number of parliamentarians when they decide to if they were decide to stick together and vote as a bloc their decisions the decision making would be based on ideological commitment idealism on how they perceive the performance of the government both in terms of governance and the carrying out of the substance of the policy measures and so on so they would vote according to the substance of the issues okay or according to the set of issues so that was a very principal thing and it makes it transparent and so on and in tune with the democratic processes and so on but in the case of Thai politics these 30 seats the look of it that is that they're going to vote either for the government or for the opposition not based on ideology idealism or on their perception and understanding of the substance of the I think the running of government and so on, or the performance. But it's more very much has to do with the reciprocity, in the sense that if I voted for you, Prime Minister Prayuth, or if I voted for you, leader of the opposition, it would mean that you have to give me something. And it could not be helped for everyone in Thailand to think that money do come into being. So money politics seems to be the name of the game, but not the idealism and or the political ideology that would come into being. So it has become a sort of a, I think, negative, grayish, lucrative political business. And this is sad for democracy, sad for the morality of the country. And this is going on. So what should we do? I think there are two sets of people that have to undertake, I think, some countermeasures. I think besides the Prime Minister or the leader of the opposition, they have to think twice whether they go along this line of political gambling, which is moral. And we hope that they would have the good sense of not going into that direction of using money to set the course of politics. And this is the first pleading to both General Prayuth Chan Ocha as the Prime Minister and also to the set of leaders in the opposition side that they have to act in a transparent, moralistic manner. But if they fail to do so, then I think the responsibility would have to be passed on to a set of independent bodies or organs like the Constitutional Court, Administrative Court, the Anti-Corruption or Counter-Corruption Commission, to the Ombudsman Office and so on. So all of these institutions would have to take at it and do the monitoring whether money politics do come into play in the course of the next few days and so on, or until the month of May when the parliament reopens. But if all of these independent bodies fail to act or to carry out the responsibility, then I think the onus would come to the third level, namely the citizens of Thailand as a whole. I think we all have to come out to reprimand both the government side and the opposition side. Second, to push the independent bodies to do the monitoring and to ensure that nothing bad and detrimental to the democratization process of Thailand would ever to occur, and so on. And at the same time, and if all of that fail, then I think the voice of the people would have to be expressed on the street. There would be rallies and so on, you know, to push all of this wrongdoers from the government side, opposition side, independent bodies that do not do anything and so on, for them to leave the scene. They should resign and let Thailand start anew again on the democratization process. So this is something that I would like to leave for you to ponder about, and whatever ideas that could be put together to push for a sort of a more governance in the affairs of Thailand, I think it would be very highly appreciated. Thank you very much. ขอบคุณมากครับ